Now, these changes are not pan-India. I would like to first clarify by saying these changes are not pan-India, meaning these are not changes made at an all-India level, but several state governments in India have made changes to their labor laws. And the changes are broadly of four kinds. The first kind of change is extension of the hours of work. And 12 states in India have extended the hours of work from 8 hours a day to 12 hours a day, and from 48 hours a week to 72 hours a week. As you all know, the Hours of Work Convention, the very first convention of the ILO, it stipulates a maximum of 8 hours of work a day and 48 hours of work a week. Then the second kind of change is exemption from the application of various labor laws. But this has still not become law. It's only in a draft stage, and it is unlikely that the president will give his assent to this because the ILO has intervened. Then the third kind of change is increase in the threshold numbers for the application of labor laws. In India, all these labor laws have threshold numbers for the application of the law. So when the numbers are increased, it means more workers are pushed outside the coverage of the law. And the fourth kind of change is exemption from regular labor inspection.
The government, instead of protecting the workers, have issued notification of increasing the working hours from 8 to 10 with no extra wages. And most importantly, suspension of Trade Unions Act. The informal sector workers were even earlier not protected by law. And if this ordinance passes, then the workers will have no rights in India.
Deteriorating labor rights and opening the door for exploitation of workers is not the answer. Instead of lowering labor rights of organized workers to the level of informal workers, the ambition should be the other way around, to raise their conditions to the level of organized workers.